Hi guys, we are out today and I just thought I would come on here and talk to you about some things that have been on my mind. And I'm going to go through them real quickly because we are trying to like really enjoy the rest of the day. And I wanted to talk to you about something that I saw on Wendy Williams last week. I know I keep moving the camera. Let me see if I can get it at an angle that I can just stay with. Okay. Here goes. I don't know if this angle is going to work, but we will see. I wanted to talk to you about Bill Cosby. I have been listening to certain other leaders in the national arena of the African American society. People like Judge Joe Brown and Judge Mathis, Judge Greg Mathis, and even Felicia Rashad. And there are very few of us out here who believe that there was a miscarriage of justice done to Bill Cosby. And you can say what you want to say about the generation that I come from, but we are, I would say we are smarter and wiser than some in this current generation. Not to say that you're not smart or wise, but we have seen a lot of things. And we know that, I know for example for me, when it came to Bill Cosby, first of all, I do not agree with drugging any drink and trying to coerce women involuntarily into having sexual relations with you. I do not agree with that. Whether you're black, white, Indian, Latino, Asian, whatever, no woman's body and her mind should be treated in such a way. That being said, I also have to look at where I come from and with some of the white women who accused Bill Cosby of raping them, because there were about 60 women, they said, and about two of them were African American. And for you all who may know this or not know this, it is very common, or it was very common back in my day, for the W's, the women of that culture, to accuse black men of doing things to them that black men did not do to them. It was very common. And the hate is real in the community. It is real. They fake it, and they don't want us to talk about slavery in the schools. They don't want us to talk about black history because they feel guilty for what their ancestors did, and they do not want to apologize for that because they did not do it. So I have a lot of questions. I wasn't there, so I cannot say what did and did not happen. I'm glad I was not there. At the same time, I have to look at the history of the accusations that have been made against men like Bill Cosby. Now, and people seem to forget, this man lost his son. He lost his son. And allegedly, it was all because he was trying to get involved in the NBC and or ABC or one of those stations. He was trying to really buy out one of the stations. And that is allegedly why that happened to his son. People say that that was a setup, that thing that happened to his son. So I just wanted to talk about that. And here's the other thing. I completely concur with Judge Joe Brown. Now, I'm not going to quote some of what he said. If you want to know what he said, this weekend he was on Kwame. I think Kwame the basketball player. His channel is Kwame Bust for Life or something like that. Also, he was on another channel as well, and her name is Dana. She's another YouTuber out here. So I completely concur with him because it just, some of it just doesn't make sense. And then you have one of the women who continued to see him because she has a baby by him. And she is one of the 60 who was accusing him as well. It just, you know, I don't have enough information to conclude on anything. Thus far, the information I have I'm just going to say there was a miscarriage of justice done somewhere. That being said, a man ought not ever cheat on his wife, committing adultery. This shows you that even if he is innocent, in the end, he was committing adultery. So that'll get you in the end. So maybe this was his, you know, payment for that. And to the young lady, to the young lady who was on Wendy Williams, the columnist, the black columnist, who has a dress on that I have, so I know where she got that dress, okay? At any rate, she said that Bill Cosby needed to give back to the community. Take this time and give back to the community. Can someone please inform her and Wendy Williams both that Bill Cosby has given in excess of $100 million to the black community? So she can GTH. If you don't know what that means, it's go to, you know, where. She can GTH, for real. She doesn't know what she's talking about. Some of those columnists get on these stations and they have all of this information to say and all of their information to put out there, and they haven't done their research. And so whenever they start to communicate information, the information is really quite unfair because they are not looking at everything. They're only looking inside of their head and what they think, and they're not bringing the facts. Because the facts are, he gave all of that money to the HBCUs. And some of the HBCUs, from what I understand, took him off their roster as being someone who has donated to them. Look, black universities, don't do that. Don't do that, okay? Stay out of it. Stay out of it. Let justice have its way, and you stay out of it. And so he is planning to do a documentary, and he is also planning to go on and do live tours. I think he's really up in age, too old to be doing live tours, so he must need the money. That's all, you know, that's all I wanted to say about Bill Cosby. Let's see here. The other thing I wanted to talk about is the Champlain Towers. You guys, this thing is really, the more I read about it, the more it's becoming a mystery as well. You have, before the Champlain Towers collapse, and I did look at some of the information that architects were putting out there about the Champlain Towers, and in Florida, these are the towers that just collapsed in Florida last week. I do believe the architectural information when it talks about the flooding in the basement, the cracks in the rebar. The rebar was very old, and the rebar is what it expands whenever it is trying to hold up the building. That's all I know about the rebar, okay? You can do your research yourself. At any rate, that rebar was rusted, so it could not expand. The water damage was so deep ingrained that it had caused the bacteria to eat through the building. And bacteria can become millions, I mean gazillions, billions, you know, and it does eat through things. And they're thinking that's what happened to the building. Even if that is what happened to the building, one of the things I noticed is whenever they were showing pictures in the building, the building had what most buildings have that are that tall. They had towers. The towers are the columns that help hold the building up. So I wonder what those columns were made of, because that building had been there, I think, like 40 years or so. And why didn't those columns hold that building up? And why weren't those columns, you know, inspected? And if they were inspected, what happened? So that's one side of that story, right? The other side of that story, and I'm doing this from my phone. I hope it doesn't go out because the battery is dying, okay, as we speak. But the other side of that story is this. I don't know how John McAfee came into play. Some of you are familiar with McAfee, the antivirus software. I've used it before. John McAfee is the, he's the one who started that antivirus software. He is a software mogul. And he started it back in the 90s, but he also gave it up in the 90s. So that was almost 30 years ago. That was a long time ago. That being said, he did go on to create other types of technology, his latest being the cryptocurrency, which he also sold to another company. He was notorious for creating software and selling it. So that being said, the U.S. government says that John McAfee hid $23 million in earnings from cryptocurrency. And that's why they were after him for tax evasion and fraud. He was always on the run, and he was always, he led a pretty fast life. You can go on and read about it. I don't like to talk about people's lifestyles unless I know for a fact. It's written that he led a certain lifestyle, you know, women and the D word, you know, the D word, D-R-U-G-S word. At any rate, his last wife was a black female who he even admitted was a prostitute that he met in Vegas or California or LA or somewhere when he was being extradited from, I think, Belize to the U.S. However, he opened her up. You know, most men, I mean, when you're a married couple, there are things that you're not going to say about your husband, and there are things that your husband's not going to say out about you out of respect. One of the things that he exposed about her was that she was a prostitute, which let me know that even though he was married to her, that was completely disrespectful. Why would he have to mention how he met her if he respected her as his wife? I just thought that that was very telling about their relationship. Also in that relationship, she mentions that at one point she was being told by certain people to have him poisoned. And I was like, wow, you know? I'm bringing all of that up to say that in his last days in that Spanish prison, because he passed away on June 25th of this year, 2021, but they're saying that before he passed away, he left some tweets. I want to see if I can read them, even if I can pull them up. I'm not even going to try because I've never done that before here. I don't know, maybe.